Hello students, welcome to next video on coordinate bond or dative bond. Okay, and its characteristics also we are trying to cover in this video. So what is the learning outcome? After watching this video, student will be able to identify coordinate bond and write the formation of coordinate compound and characteristics of coordinate compound. Means in short, by looking at the compound, you can say that this is the coordinate bond. Means from the bond, how it is represented, all that we are going to study in this video. So you can identify this is coordinate bond, you can write the formation of coordinate compound and characteristic, that is the properties of coordinate compound that we are going to cover in this video. So first we will see what is the coordinate bond or dative bond. Okay, so it is the special type of covalent bond. Okay, you are knowing how covalent bonds are formed. Covalent bonds are formed by the mutual sharing. Mutual sharing means, यदि इस एटम का एक इलेक्ट्रॉन है तो दूसरा जो एलिमेंट है उसका भी एक इलेक्ट्रॉन रहेगा. मीन्स म्यूचुअल शेयरिंग, इसका एक है तो उसका भी एक है, दैट इज कॉल्ड द म्यूचुअल. ओके, सो हियर कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड, इन कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड म्यूचुअल शेयरिंग इज देयर, बट इन कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कोऑर्डिनेट एंड कोवेलेंट, दैट यू विल कम टू नो लेटर ऑन. सो इट इज ऑल्सो द टाइप ऑफ कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड इन विच शेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड बाय द वन एटम ओनली. Okay, like previous one, in covalent both are mutually shared. In covalent bond mutual sharing of electron is there, but in coordinate bond what is difference there? Electrons are shared by the one atom only. Only one atom is going to share the electron, while other atom it is going to accept that without sharing, without contribution of any electron. Okay, again I'm going to repeat, covalent bond is a mutual sharing, whereas in coordinate bond, or it is also called the dative bond, what is happening there? In coordinate or dative bond, one atom is going to share the both the electron. Okay, one atom is going to share both the electron, while other atom is going to take, going to accept that electron without contribution of electron. Means it is not having any contribution, it is going to take only that electron. Okay, so let us proceed further. Now when we are going to discuss the example, that time we will be much more clear about that. So atom which contribute the electron pair, that electron pair we are going to call as a lone pair. Now are you remembering lone pair? See, I have given you the example of we have seen the example of water molecule in last video. Now here I would like to give you the example of hydrogen. See here, hydrogen. In hydrogen, how many electrons are there? One electron is there. Ammonia, you are knowing the ammonia. What is the formula of ammonia? NH3. Okay. So, in the center, nitrogen is there. Nitrogen atomic number is 7. So, its electronic configuration is 2, 5. So, in last orbit, 5 electrons are there. And the electrons of this nitrogen, I am going to show like this dot mark. And here is one dot. Okay. So, another hydrogen, 3 hydrogen are there, one is here and another is here. Okay. So see here, this hydrogen wants to complete its duplet. For completion duplet, how many electrons are needed? One electron. So it is going to share one electron with this. Okay. Similarly, this hydrogen is also going to share one electron with the neighboring nitrogen. And here also, there is a sharing. So here, one pair is shared, here is also one pair is shared, and here is also one pair is shared, and one lone pair is there. So here I'm going to represent like this. So if there is a single sharing of one pair is shared, only one pair is shared, that time which bond is formed? Single covalent bond is formed here. Okay, getting to me? Here single covalent bonds are formed. So in ammonia molecule, how many single covalent bonds are present? Here is a 3 single covalent bond and one lone pair is present. Lone pair means it is not taking part in the bond formation. So they are going to call, it is called as a lone pair. So one lone pair is here. And this lone pair, the molecule which is having the lone pair, they are going to form the coordinate bond. ज्या मॉलिक्यूल मध्ये लोन पेयर असतात तेच फक्त कोऑर्डिनेट कंपाउंड मध्ये भाग घेऊ शकतात. ओके, सो सी हियर, ॲटम विच कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट द इलेक्ट्रॉन पेअर, आता या केसमध्ये विच इज गोइंग टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट, नायट्रोजन इज गोइंग टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट, इट इज कॉल्ड द डोनार. जो डोनेट देतो त्याला काय म्हणायचं, डोनार म्हणायचं. व्हाईल अदर ॲटम शेअर्स दिस, जर दुसरा जो कोण असतो तो काय करतो, एक्सेप्ट करतो, म्हणून त्याला काय म्हणायचं, एक्सेप्टर. इज इट क्लिअर? डोनार विच इज गोइंग टू गिव्ह, जो कोण कुठला आयटम देत असतो, ज्याच्यावर लोन पेअर आहे तो काय करत असतो, डोनेट. इन दिस केस नायट्रोजन इज अ डोनार आयटम. ओके, जेव्हा आपण फॉर्मेशन बघू तेव्हा एक्सेप्टर कुठला आहे तेही तुम्हाला कळेल. फक्त मला या एक्झाम्पल मधून तुम्हाला काय सांगायचं होतं, इन अमोनिया थ्री सिंगल कोवॅलेंट बॉन्ड अँड वन लोन पेअर इज प्रेझेंट. ओनली मॉलिक्युल्स हॅव्हिंग द लोन पेअर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन दे आर गोइंग टू कॉन्ट्रीब्युट इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड. ओके, आणि ज्याच्यावर लोन पेअर असतं त्याला आपण डोनार ऍटम म्हणणार आहे, जो काय करत असतो, हे पेअर शेअर करत असतो. ओके, सो सी हियर, द कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड ऑर डेटिव बॉन्ड इट इज रिप्रेझेंटेड बाय द एरो हेड. कशाने डिनोट करतात, हे सिंपल एरोन हे करायचं. आता हा एरो पण डिनोट करताना कुठून, जो डोनेट करतो त्याच्याकडे हे टेल, आणि एरोचं हेड कुणाकडे पाहिजे, जो एक्सेप्ट करतो, जो घेतो, एक्सेप्टर जो आहे त्याच्याकडे ह्याचा एरोचं हेड असायला हवं. सो कॉर्डिनेट बॉन्ड इट इज रिप्रेझेंटेड बाय द एरो हेड स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम डोनार, डोनार पासून स्टार्ट करायचं अँड एंडिंग ॲट द एक्सेप्टर. तर एक्झाम्पल कुठल्या कॉर्डिनेट कंपाऊंडचं आपण बघणार आहोत, अमोनियम मॉलिक्यूल. डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज, अमोनिया फॉर्म्युला ऑफ अमोनिया इज NH3 अँड अमोनियम आयन दॅट इज द NH4+. सो कॉर्डिनेट एक्झाम्पल ऑफ कॉर्डिनेट कंपाऊंड इज द अमोनियम, नॉट अमोनिया. अमोनिया इज द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट, सॉरी कोवॅलंट कंपाऊंड. हे कशाचं एक्झाम्पल आहे, दिस इज द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड अँड दिस इज द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड. इज इट क्लिअर? This is the example of coordinate bond, or it is also called dative bond. Okay, so let us proceed further. See here, formation of ammonium molecule. In ammonia molecule, ata ammonium cha apan formation baghtoy, pan kasha pasun honar hai, how it is formed? It is formed, see here, kay kay asnar hai tyachya madhe, ammonia asnar hai, ammonia cha molecule ahe, ani hydrogen H+ ion. या दोघांच्या कॉम्बिनेशननं जो फॉर्म होत असतो दॅट इज द अमोनियम आयन. इन अमोनिया मॉलिक्युल थ्री सिंगल कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड्स आर प्रेझेंट. ॲज आय मेन्शन ऑलियर इन माय प्रिव्हियस स्लाइड आय हॅव एक्सप्लेन यू, इन अमोनिया थ्री सिंगल कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड्स आर प्रेझेंट. इन अमोनिया नायट्रोजन ॲटम हॅज अनशेअर्ड पेअर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विच फॉर्म अ कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड विथ हायड्रोजन आयन. ओके, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू हियर. सी हियर, आपण मगाशी बघितलं होतं, थोडंसं मी वेगळं स्ट्रक्चर काढते, ही लोन पेअर इकडे दाखवूयात आपण. अँड हिअर इज अ सिंगल कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड विथ द हायड्रोजन, दॅट नायट्रोजन इज हॅव्हिंग द सिंगल कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड विथ द हायड्रोजन, दिस इज लोन पेअर. अँड विच वन इज गोइंग टू रिॲक्ट, H+ मीन्स हाऊ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देअर, नो इलेक्ट्रॉन. ॲक्च्युली इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ हायड्रोजन इज वन ओनली. ओके, when it is going to form H+ means this electron is also lost, means it is not having any electron. So to complete the duplet, how many electrons are needed? 2. So these 2 electrons, they are taken by this nitrogen. Here I will show you. So this N, it is going to give the electron to this hydrogen atom, and here there is a formation of single covalent bond is there. Okay, here there is a formation of single covalent bond, and this lone pair they are going to share with this hydrogen ion, and here coordinate bond is formed between these two. So here which one is donor? Nitrogen is donor. This nitrogen is donor atom, while H+ it is the acceptor atom. So when the coordinate bond is formed, how it is represented? It is written in the square bracket, big square bracket. This is the hydrogen, this is hydrogen, this is hydrogen. Here lone pair is shared. You have to, how it is represented? Coordinate bond is represented by the arrow starting from the donor to the acceptor, and on that square bracket you have to write the positive charge. That's why this ammonium NH4+. Okay, so always remember, in ammonium ion which bond is present? In ammonium ion, coordinate bond is present. Okay, so by looking at the molecule also, sometime in exam, examples are given. Okay, in that this arrow is written. So when arrow is present, that time you have to say which compound it is. It is a coordinate compound. Okay, Let us proceed for the CR, formation of coordinate compound. Same only here, it is explained here. This is hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Three hydrogen and this is nitrogen. Its electronic configuration 2, 5. So 5 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is lone pair and one electron of the hydrogen. They are going to form the single covalent bond. So 3 single covalent bonds are present. And this lone pair, it is shared with this H plus ion, hydrogen ion. See here. And how it is represented? It is represented by the arrow starting from this donor and ending towards the acceptor. So donor means which is going to share the electron. Both the electrons are shared by that nitrogen only. Here hydrogen is not going to contribute any electron. Okay, so nitrogen is donor and hydrogen is the acceptor. And see here it is written here coordinate bond. How it is written? It is represented by the arrow. Okay, and on the bracket you have to show its charge, that is plus. Okay, this is the ammonium ion. This is about the coordinate compound. Now, same that only I have shown here orbital diagram, electron rich. This is also called electron rich, and this is the H plus is electron deficient center. So it is going to take this electron. That's why here arrow headed, arrow is shown here, pointing towards the hydrogen. So this is acceptor and this is the donor. So always remember, coordinate bond, it is represented by arrow. Okay. Next, we are going to start the properties of coordinate compound. So see, already we have seen the properties of electrovalent compound, covalent compound. Okay. So now we are going to see the properties of coordinate compound. First property is that, okay, this compound having melting point and boiling point higher than the purely covalent compound and lower than the purely ionic compound. Means they are having in between these two. Okay. Means they are having, suppose this is your coordinate compound. Okay. This is coordinate compound. Here it is ionic compound. Ionic having the higher melting point, boiling point. Coordinate, it is having higher than the covalent. So covalent having the less melting point and boiling point as compared to these two. Okay, coordinate, it is the in between these two. Okay, coordinate compounds are melting point, boiling point ha ionic peksha kami asto, tar covalent compound peksha kasa asto, jast asto. Okay, this is about the first property. Next, these are sparingly soluble in polar solvents. Sparingly means what? Partially soluble. These are not complete soluble in the polar solvent. Okay. Polar solvent, example I have given you, water. Water, H2O. How it is going to form the ion? H plus and OH minus. That's why it is called the polar. Two poles are developed. That's why it is called the polar solvent. Always remember, water is the polar solvent. So, this coordinate compound, say coordinate compound, they are sparingly soluble in the polar solvent, but readily soluble in the non-polar solvent. Non-polar solvent like your benzene, carbon disulfide, in that they are the readily soluble, but whereas in polar solvent, they are sparingly soluble. Okay. Now, covalent compounds, these are like covalent compounds, these are also bad conductor of electricity. As we are knowing, covalent compound, there is no ions, so they are not going to conduct the electricity. Same like that, covalent compound, these coordinate compounds are also the bad conductor of electricity. Next, these bonds are rigid and directional. Okay, these are also same like the coordinate compound, these are also the rigid and directional one. Whereas electrovalent bonds, they are the non-directional. Non-directional means they can be extended in all the direction. Okay, but here in coordinate and covalent, they are the directional one. Coordinate covalent bond is the property of atom that have lone pair of electron. Always remember, this bond consists of lone pair of electron, and that lone atom which bears that lone pair of electron, it act as a donor while other act as an acceptor. Coordinate bonding is found in complex chemical compound. Remember, coordinate bond kashamadhe present asto, it is present in the complex chemical compounds. Okay, so these are the properties of coordinate compound. We will stop here. This is all about the coordinate bond, its formation and its properties. Thank you.